Hello there, Final Cut Pro users. It's Brett Williams from BretFX.com here again. In this tutorial, I want to show you my take on using snapshots, duplicates, and compound clips, all for the exciting purpose of project versioning. I'll also touch a little bit on using smart collections to keep all these versions organized. So if you're interested in seeing more tutorials like this, please, I'd love a subscription to my channel and click the little bell down there so that you're notified anytime a new video comes out. But hey, enough of my yakking. What do you say? Let's boogie. Okay, so for this tutorial, we're focusing on a brand new fictional series called Outdoor Explorer. Whenever I create a new library, I like to start with at least two events, one for my projects and at least one more for all my media. In the projects event here, we've just completed episode 1, version 1, a first pass, and let's say we've sent it off to the client and we're waiting for feedback. So in the meantime, let's take a look. We also have these two compound clips here, which make up the show open down here in the timeline in the intro composite. That refers to this compound intro composite. And if you double click on it and look inside there, there's another compound clip called Show Title, and that is referencing this compound right up here in the browser. So let's take a look at this compound. The bottom layer is our little guy on the canoe going across the lake. And then right above it is our Show Title, which, as I said, is a compound clip unto itself. So let's double click on that and see what that's made of. We have some animated 3D text, Outdoor Explorer, and then right above that, we have another layer of animated 3D text, which is the name of our first episode, Canoeing. Both of these layers have a reflection effect added to it from BretFX.com, the BretFX Reflect plugin, and that does two things. It, applies this kind of transparent, blurry reflection to the text, but it also enables this sort of a reveal effect, so it looks like it's coming out of the water when we go back to the main composite. And since that reflection is actually going over our canoeist's head here, I've duplicated the lower layer, the lower canoeist layer up on top here, but I've added an animated draw mask over him. And this could be a whole tutorial unto itself. But I outlined him with kind of a little feathered mask, and I've used some keyframes to just move the mask along with the canoeist. And that puts him in front of the reflection. So the Outdoor Explorer canoeing is sort of sandwiched in between the full canoe layer and the sort of cutout mast layer. I'm going to go ahead and close the inspector. So the point here is that our intro composite is a fairly complicated little compound clip. All right, so we've gotten changes back from the client now, and they like everything. They just realized that, you know, later on in the show, it's not all about canoeing. We've got some kayaking going on here. So they think that canoeing isn't quite appropriate. They want to change the name to paddle sports, which would include kayaking as well. So this is where we want to make some decisions about our versioning workflow. We don't want to change version 1. We want to keep this. So we can either duplicate it or we can create a snapshot. So if we duplicate it, we could easily run into some trouble with these compound clips. So let's take a look. Let's duplicate it. And we're going to change the duplicate to version 2. I'm going to double click on that. Make sure we're editing version 2. And here's our intro composite with the canoeing title. Let's double click on that. And the show title here with the graphics. Let's double click on that. And this top layer is the canoeing. So let's open up the inspector and go back to the titling. I'm going to change canoeing to paddle sports. And looks like I need to kind of move that over a little bit. Let's press the back arrow to go back to our main intro composite here. And the back arrow again to go to the main timeline. I'm going to close the inspector to give us a little more room. And so it looks good. We've changed the episode title to Paddle Sports. But the problem that we've created is both of these, version 1 and version 2, both have the same compound clip embedded in them. That's what happens when you do a duplicate. All the compounds, multicams, still refer to the same instances of these compound clips. So if I double-click to open episode 1, we've actually changed episode 1 to now say Paddle Sports as well. And we didn't want that. So let's undo. Go back a few steps here. Command-Z, Command-Z, Command-Z until we don't have our duplicate anymore. Let's double-click on episode 1, make sure it's right. Okay, so we've gone back to canoeing. We're back to where we were when we got the notes back from the client. And instead of doing a simple duplicate of version 1, let's duplicate the project as a snapshot. I find it much safer, much simpler, and easier to simply duplicate as a snapshot and then come up here to our working version 1 and increment that to version 2. So this snapshot, it's moved up here now because it's alphabetical. So the snapshot, when you create a snapshot, it duplicates all the compound clips and kind of hides them away. They're hidden from view unless you open it up and edit it. But as a policy, I never edit a snapshot. Snapshots to me are for emergencies only, and even if a client were to come back and they want to go revert back to an old version, a snapshotted version, I would even then make a snapshot of the snapshot and work on that. So the only way you're going to change a snapshot is if you open it up and edit it. So to prevent that from happening, a good idea might be to make a smart collection and make it your policy when you're looking at which projects to open up and edit to go to your smart collection. So we already have one pre-made that comes with every library called Projects. So we can double-click on the Project Smart Collection, and in here we can see the settings for it. We can see that it's showing all media that is of the type Project. So we're seeing the snapshot and the current working version of our project. What we can do here is we can click on the little plus and add a new filter for text. And so now it's showing all media that's of the type project that also includes, we want to change this to that does not include the word snapshot. And right away, the snapshot disappeared over here in our Project Smart Collection. So if you always go to your Project Smart Collection you've kind of edited here, it'll always show you the current working projects. Now you might also want a Smart Collection that shows you the just the snapshots, so I can press Command-D to duplicate that. Let's rename this to Snapshots. You might want to call it Backups or Do Not Edit, you know, whatever works for you. And let's double-click on that to change its criteria. The only thing we need to change is the text field. We want to say it includes the text snapshot. And right away, this now only is showing snapshots. So you've got two smart collections here now, your projects, which is kind of your working projects, the ones that you're currently editing. And once you've exported them and given them to the client for review, and they come back with their changes, you want to snapshot them. And you can even do it right after you export if you like. And so these snapshots won't change unless somebody decides to double click on them and edit them. So let's go back to our projects. So let's double-click on episode 1, version 2. And we'll do the same thing and dig into our compound clip, the intro composite, and then dig into show title, and we'll make those changes the client wanted. Go to our canoeing text and change it to paddle sports again. Gonna need to move that over to the left a little bit. Looks pretty good there. I'm gonna click the back arrow to go back out again. The main timeline, let's close up the inspector. We've got it all looking nice. So I'm about ready to send this off to the client for approval, but I get word at the last moment they want to create also a short version that doesn't include the kayaking here at the end. So this might be a good example of when you want to use a duplicate of a sequence, since the short version is just going to be a derivative of the same cut, and it's going to use the same intro graphics. And so you might want both of those versions to link back to the same compound clips for the intro graphics in case they decide, after we've made 10 derivatives, that they want all of the show opens to be called paddling instead of paddle sports, for example. So instead of making a snapshot of version 2, I haven't exported this out to the client yet, I'm going to right-click and duplicate the project. And I'm going to call this one Episode 1, Version 2. It's still based off of the version 2 cut, short. And we'll give that version 1. So we've got Episode 1, Version 2 with the new paddle sports title, and Episode 1, Version 2, short. And I'm going to double-click on that. And we'll go down here and get rid of all the kayaking. And I'm going to press Shift-Command-B to split through everything in the timeline. And just select all of that and delete. And we'll press Shift-Z to kind of expand it back out to fill the timeline. And so now we export out our version 2. And we've exported out our short version. And the client's taking a look at them. And they come back with one change. They realize in the short version, let's double click on that, that because it doesn't have kayaking in it, they can go back to the original name of canoeing. But they want to keep the long version named paddle sports. So we're not going to change version 2, the long version here. That one's good. They like it. But the short version, we're going to go ahead and do the same snapshot. We're going to duplicate the project as a snapshot. And for some reason, Final Cut always goes and highlights the event after you make a snapshot. But we can see it's here in the snapshots now. Let's go back to our working projects. And we're going to rename this short version. Episode 1, Version 2. I think I still like the Version 2 because it's based off the same cut. But we're going to increment that short version 1 to short version 2. And double click on that to open that up. And we don't want to edit this compound though, because it's still linked back to the same compounds in the long version. But this is a good opportunity to show you how you can take this compound here, select the compound in the timeline, go up to Clip, and choose Reference New Parent Clip. And down here in the timeline, it has automatically created a new compound clip and replaced the compound in the timeline. And you can see it says Intro Composite Copy Now. And this compound will be found back in our events. So we now have three compound clips in here. The Intro Composite Copy, and the show title. So let's double click on that to change paddle sports back to canoeing. There's still another compound inside this new intro composite copy. And that compound is still linked back. If we change this, it is going to change the long version as well. So we still need to select this show title, go up to clip, and say reference new parent clip for it as well. And you can see it says Show Title Copy. And back in our Projects event, there's now four compound clips here. Show Title Copy, Show Title, Intro Composite Copy, and Intro Composite. And you can rename these to make more sense if you need to. So let's double click on our Show Title Copy. Open the inspector and change Paddle Sports back to Canoeing. And I think we can slide it over to the right a little bit now. Okay, so let's click the back arrow to get out of here and the back arrow to get back to the main timeline. Great, so our short version 2. Let's go back to the Project Smart Collection to make sure we're looking at the right things. So we've got our long version 2. it still says paddle sports. And the one we just edited, the short version, version 2, is we've changed it back to canoeing. So that's about all I've got for you. We'll send these two projects off to the client and hope that we're golden. Now that you know how these concepts work, it's really up to you to decide what's prudent for your versioning workflow. When to do a snapshot, when to duplicate a sequence, and even when to take a compound clip and reference a new parent clip. So thanks for watching. Be sure to like and subscribe and click the little bell there to get notified of new videos in the future. Have a great day and happy editing.